Heaven make thee free of it. I follow thee. I am dead, Horatio. Wretched queen, adieu. You look pale and tremble at this chance, that are but mutes or audience in this act. Had I but mine, and time, as this fell sergeant, death, is strict in his arrest. Oh, I can tell you, but let it be, Horatio, I am dead. Thou livest, report me and my cause, all right, to the unsatisfied.
Never believe it. I mourn ancestrous Rome than a day. There's yet some liquor left.
No. As thou art a man, give me the cup. Let go, by heaven, I'll have it. Oh, good Horatio, what a wounded name. Things standing thus unknown shall live behind me. If thou didst ever hold in that me in thy heart, absent thee from felicity a while, and in this harsh world, draw thy breath in pain to tell my story. What warlike ball is this?
Young Ford brought with conquest come from Poland. The ambassadors of England give the warlike volley.
Oh, I die, Horatio. The potent poison quiet overcrowns my spirit. I cannot live to hear the news from England. But I do prophecy in the election lights on foreign brawl. He has my dying voice, so tell him, with this occurrence, more and less, which have solicited, the rest is silence.
Now cracks a noble heart. Good night, sweet prince, and flights of angels, sing to thy rest. Why does the drum come hither? No
tomorrow. Where is this sight?
What is it you would see? Not woe or wonder, cease your search.
His quarry cries in heaven, O proud death. What feast is toward thy eternal cell? That thou shall meet princes at a shop, so bloodly struck?
The sight is dismal, and our affairs come from England too late. The ears are senseless that should give us hearing. To tell him his commandment is fulfilled, that Rosencrantz and Guildenstern are dead, where should we have our thanks?
Not from his mouth, had the ability of life to thank you. He never gave commandment for their death, but since so jump upon this bloody question, you from the Polack wars, and you from England, and here arrived, give order to these bodies, high the stage we place them you. And let me speak to the yet unknown world, how these things came about, so shall you hear, of carnal, bloody, and unnatural acts, of accidental judgments, casual slaughters, of deaths put on by cunning and force and cause, and in this upshot, purposes mistook, fallen on and vengeance breeds, all this I can I truly deliver.
To hear it, and call the noblest to the audience. For me, with sorrow, I embrace my fortune. I have some rights of memory to this kingdom, which now claim thy vantage doth abide.
Of that I shall have cause to speak, and from his mouth, whose voice will draw on more. But let this same be presently performed, and while men's minds are wild, lest more mischance have plots and errors have more.
Let four captain, barehanded like a soldier, to this day, for he was likely, had he been put on, to have proved most royally, and for his passage, the soldiers' music and the rifles of war speak loudly. Take up the bodies, such a sight as this becomes the field, who here show much amiss. Go, bid the soldiers shoot,